Code Red, it's happening. The very first Tier 1 CS2 LAN is about to begin. Take everything you know about fantasy, throw it out the window. Or don't. Because who actually knows how this transition's gonna go and what the hell is about to happen? You're watching Fantasy Focus, powered by 22bet. At a moment in Counter-Strike history with so many moving parts, it's nice to have something constant. And right now, the only constant in the world, it seems, is Maniac. That's right, the very best celebrity fantasy player. Congratulations, Maniac, the man who nearly won last season, is back on top and ahead of the pack with two strong showdown drafts. I'm talking 28 points earned between the European and North American showdown, which now situates Maniac 6 points ahead of Darth Mike in second and 11 points ahead of Scrawny in third. Speaking of which, both Darth Mike and I finished as the highest amongst the celebrities for the NA and EU showdowns. If you're wondering how those wrapped up, Darth with a 3% finish, myself with a 2% in Europe, and we have now earned an extra $50 each, courtesy of 22bet, and are tied with P2 for the most events won this season. Take a look at the Big Bucks Club. 9 members from the celebrity leaderboard now in the club. 3 of us have now won multiple games this season alone. Myself, Darth, and P2. And then of course there's still the prestigious 1%ers, of which there are still only 3 exclusive members. That is Professor with his Gamers 8 1%, Nart with a Pro League Group A 1%, and Machine, Alex Richardson, as Pro League Group D 1%er. It's the most prestigious fantasy club of all, and even amongst the celebrities, still only 3 members. So keep trying, folks, we're almost done. That's right, 2/3 of the season more or less wrapped up for fantasy, so it's very clear that with this current setup, Maniac's challengers will have their hands full. They are running out of events if they are going to surpass the Swiss man. However, enter IEM Sydney, a 16-team event divided into 2 groups with a separate fantasy event for playoffs specifically. So go ahead and draft your group stagers. There's only 1 round of padding available in this format, and that 1 round of padding will apply to the 4 teams who win their upper bracket semifinals best of 3. The clearest path to playoffs could be a key when it comes to choosing your players this week, and again, especially with an event where we don't know who's gonna play well, which teams will flop, or how CS2 changes everything. But with changes comes the 22bet Knowledge Bomb. Today's Knowledge Bomb is that with the changes in match length for CS2, we have the HLTV Fantasy devs hard at work, and either for Sydney, playoffs, or moving forward, these changes will be applying to the boosters, okay? Avenger, Bait, and Assist will be going from 5 to 4 in order to activate the booster. The Cannon Fodder booster will go from 6 to 5 survived rounds, or rather non-survived rounds. And Carry will be going from 25 kills in a match down to only 20. So keep your eyes out on the boosters. Changes all over the place. Keep track if you can. And now to highlight a few players ahead of the group stage. Now, my general philosophy for big ballers is always the highest cost, but I'm applying a different rule set for this episode because I can, because it's my show, damn it. Well, mine and Lucy's. Big baller, don't spend all your money on super carries, because I think that with CS2 changing things, without knowing who's actually gonna carry over real carry potential and that level of high peak form, I just feel like dropping money on certain players is a little bit risky. Is Zywu really gonna still be that good? Can Nico be the number one rifler in a game like CS2? These questions are left unanswered, and I feel like this week I wanna focus on big ballers who come in just a little less expensive, and I think are still bang for your buck. So up first, we've got Nerds. $221,000 price tag seems solid for the hands down best rifler on Ents, who have continued to chip their way to the number one spot in the world. They're working on it, and Nerds is a reason why. You slap multi-fragger on this baddie, and all of a sudden he's racking up your points. If not Nerds, maybe Spinx. Vitality's rifler at $219,000 I think is a bit of a steal. Now coming in less than Magisk and significantly less expensive than the $238,000 Zywu, you put multi-fragger or attacker if multi-fragger is already grabbed, and I think Sphinx is an excellent price tag and still somebody who could come in with a massive rating in group stage. And then thirdly for the big ballers category, Monacy. Because Monacy is the kid that I expect to be getting grimy, all right? He's been working with CS2 in the shadows, trying to find that competitive edge that could very well elevate him into the upper echelon of players for Sydney. So slap on off, slap on entry. You know what you get with Monacy. It's that aggressive, in-your-face AWP that most teams can't handle. Safe bet. Redundant name, in my opinion, for this event, folks. IEM Sydney, CS2, it's very difficult to say anything is safe. But if you had to go down any safe route, I offer Maus. I think a double Maus draft is safe for the following reasons. One, great opening game versus some local Australians. Two, recent form coming off of ESL Pro League. Three, youthful vigor. I'm talking young, hungry players that are going to be trying to maximize this moment in their careers as they have suddenly burst onto that top stage. And honestly, the rounding factor is the price tags. I feel like right now at the moment, outside of Frozen and Torzi, the rest of Maus are very affordable, including very capable in-game leader Shuhei. And then our third and final category, where I will mention Shuhei very swiftly, is the eco pick. So Shuhei at $190,000 with the leader role feels to me like somebody that you can bank on because they've got a very clear path to playoffs. Shuhei performs as an individual, and I think that this is a great chance for these guys to just feed off of their Pro League run straight through Sydney. Again, playoffs may be a different story. We can revisit that. But for group stage, why wouldn't their current form transfer into this event? Secondly, Bro. I want to highlight JKS's son, as some call him. $184,000 and activating the headshot rule significantly. I believe that Monty is a team that you have to put stock in. If you've been keeping them under the radar, that's fine and dandy, but the time is now. 184 for Bro, somebody who on LAN has a significantly higher rating than his online performances. So at this price tag and with the run they have starting versus Complexity, Bro could definitely get you some early points for cheap. And if not Shuey or Bro, let's run it old school. Snacks, baby. The new in-game leader for Gamer Legion. Last time he stood in on a LAN at this caliber was with Ents. 2021, 2022. All I remember is that he came out of nowhere and started dropping bombs. Okay, we can't forget that Snacks is an incredible individual who has tons of LAN experience, and even though he's new to the in-game leader role with Gamer Legion, I expect that his individual form should excel his $186,000 price tag. So pick your poison, baby. Shuey, Bro, or Snacks to save a little money. Nerd, Sphinx, Monacy at the top with the big ballers and some Maus safe bets to guarantee you a great start to your CS2 fantasy endeavors. You're watching Fantasy Focus with the Scrawn Dog. Good luck, folks. You're gonna need it.